Within the last several hours, we've started to see more of the thunderstorm development off to our west, which is what models were indicating we would see. Now, they are getting close to the River Parish's North Shore, Tangipahoa. We are starting to get some of the downpours. Now, thankfully, nothing severe. A lot of lightning, some gusty winds. The setup, though, is looking less and less likely for tornadic storms. And again, that threat would be very, very limited, but more of just the strong winds and maybe even some hail associated with some of these showers. Certainly a lot of lightning, certainly some, at times, heavy downpours. But it looks like that may be our primary threats as we go through the rest of this evening and on into tonight. Again, the heaviest of the rainfall from Hammond moving north up toward Amite, some downpours between Amite and Kentwood, but not as much. A little bit of light rain in northern Washington Parish. You got some light showers at times across parts of western St. Tammany, but the bulk of the activity has been more to our west. River Parish is not too much, and then you have some light to moderate rain across St. Mary at the moment. Now, where we do have those thunderstorms, they are intense. Get the blossoming cloud tops on visible satellites showing up. So these are certainly some strong thunderstorms, but they are at the moment remaining under the severe criterion. Let's hope that continues, because we will see another chance for some strong storms tomorrow. 80 degrees was our high today, so a little bit above average. That southerly wind bringing in some high humidity as well as the warm air didn't really help us out if you were hoping for a cooler day. Mostly cloudy skies out over downtown with a temperature of 77 right now, and dew points have been in the 60s, a more humid air mass. Briefly got into the low 80s. Most of us, though, stayed in the upper 70s, low 80s. So even with that strong return flow from the Gulf of Mexico, cloud cover really prevented us from getting very warm today. And dew points, upper 60s, low 70s. It is plenty moist for the showers and thunderstorms over the next couple of days, but we will see a drop in humidity behind a cold front on early Thursday. And the winds have been brisk, and we are going to stay breezy throughout the overnight period and on into tomorrow. There's kind of two upper disturbances across the nation. One, out over the high plains. That's a severe risk that we're going to see across Kansas, Nebraska, Iowa. The one that we're a little bit more focused on is the one over central and eastern Texas. Now, the main energy with this is staying to our west. That's why the greater risk of severe weather is to our west. And look at this, watch boxes and several warnings being issued there. Not likely to see a watch for us, but certainly something that we'll have to watch for as we continue through the late night period, with most of these storms, again, generally staying off to the west. Now, the model has us pretty much clearing out by after 8:30, 9 o'clock. That'd be great. I still think we'll have some ongoing rainfall there. We might see some of the more intense rain starting to diminish. Most of the day early tomorrow will be dry. Maybe a few light passing showers, with most of the thunderstorm development beginning during the afternoon and evening. We'll likely see kind of a line of storms unassociated or ahead of the front by tomorrow night. So this will be kind of an ongoing threat starting in the afternoon through the evening and after dark. Again, this is all for tomorrow. This is not for tonight. Wednesday night, front sweeps on through. We'll likely still see some ongoing storms even after midnight. And then as the front sweeps on through, clearing out for the rest of the day on Thursday, and also turning a bit less humid. So that's why we have the outlook for severe weather mainly to our west today. Tomorrow, we see more of a focus north of us. However, we are being placed under a level 2 risk, so something that we don't want to take lightly, but usually a 1 and 2 for us is pretty typical, an isolated strong to severe storm possible. But also with some of these downpours, we are under a risk of some heavy rainfall, especially out to our west today. And then for tomorrow, any of the downpours that we see, especially if we get kind of a training of rain, would also lead to probably more of a street flooding threat than anything else. So severe weather threat, heavy rain threat through tomorrow night and into early on Thursday. And Thursday, the rain chances are primarily early. A few spotty showers are possible on Good Friday, and then really just an isolated rain chance for the Easter weekend, actually relatively dry. A few more thunderstorms Monday and a little milder as we get into next Tuesday.
Yeah, and we